I don't even know what I'm getting. I have such a headache. I'm so discombobulated. Oh, let me get this. I am so exhausted, but I'm just gonna make this errand really quick because I cannot be late to meet Vic for dinner. How are you? Do you know who I am? You know, I'm able to communicate with people that have died, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
Spirit spirit.
Yes. I want to talk about mother energy. I heard she missed my passing and not wanting you to feel bad or upset about that.
I was in the airport. My sister called up. She said my mother that, but I don't attend.
Okay. Uh-huh. It's mom's way of saying that nothing was left unsaid and she loves you and is so proud of you. I gotta go. I'm late to meet my daughter for dinner. All right, let's go see. Whew, I feel a little nauseous. I don't really feel that good. Oh, you know what I need? I need a pudding. You know the fat-free pudding and the Jell-O? That's what I'm looking for. I've been looking for you.
I've been looking for you. Oh my goodness.
I beat you to it. Do you know who I am?
Yes, I do. My name is Stacy, and I live right here in Hicksville.
You know that intuition, that gut instinct, the little Jiminy Cricket?
Yes.
That is spirit. So the same way when I saw you, I go, I've been looking for you. I don't say that to people.
No.
And that's what you said to me. You go, I've been looking for you.
I have. I've been waiting. I knew I was going to meet you.
See?
I have had the vibe and the intuition for the last, let's say, 5 years that I am going to run into Theresa. She's going to find me. And when I walked in today, she looked at me and said, I found you. Oh my God, you're here. So just like I had envisioned.
I had this crazy idea today that I had all these errands to do. And I was just gonna let Spirit do their thing. Just guide me. And I am exhausted. I'm an hour late for dinner.
And your hands are freezing.
My
just
hands
like mine.
Are freezing. No, you're not. Oh, you're warm. You're actually warm.
Well, that's a menopausal
how do you know?
Thing.
Yeah. Just so you know, Rod, I didn't bring the word up. Tell them what you said.
Menopausal thing. It's been some adventure,
okay,
Theresa.
Okay, they want to kill me because this is all I talk about. So now this is my new thing, menopause. Men need to take a pause from us women.
Permanently.
Stay back.
Permanently.
Listen, I'm going through menopause. It's going to affect everyone and anything in my life, whether it's my crew, Spirit, my parents, my dog. If you don't like it, there's the door. So now, see, you're helping me out because I actually feel better when I channel. So I have this, like, pressure in this chest, but almost like this pain, and then they snap their fingers at me, which is my symbol for that they died suddenly, and then not having the ability to say goodbye.
Yes.
How do you connect with the mom that's departed, or someone like a mother to you?
Mom.
Okay.
My mother was in a very tragic drowning accident approximately 30 years ago. Losing mom at the time I did was soul-crushing. I was just about to get married. She died a few days before my wedding, and she missed out on her grandchildren and the birth of them and my whole life, basically, because life starts at around 30.
She's adorable. She's like, keep praying and talking to me, and I'm gonna be there for you.
How nice is
but
that?
But how adorable is she? But
yes.
That would be her, right?
Yes. My relationship with my mom was so connected in such a deep way, more than a typical mother-daughter relationship. I miss my mom horribly, intensely. Every day I think about her.
So there's something about your mom, how strong she is. How do you connect with the month of January? I saw Jan, so I don't know if that's a name or...
My middle name.
Shut up, because like she goes like this.
She goes,
it's not January. She goes, it's a name. And I'm like...
Jan is my middle name.
Shut up!
Yes.
And I don't know, but she's always like, come, are you hungry? Like, now she's going to cook for me. She goes, you look parched. You need something to drink.
Sounds like my mom.
But then she showed me her pots.
The pots. My brother got the big stew pot.
That you wanted.
That I still want. Giving me goosebumps again.
But what a beautiful thing for your mom to validate that you have kept the things that really have no monetary value.
And also just you validating that she is aware of the stew pot situation.
Exactly. That validates that they're at peace and more importantly that they are okay.
Theresa brought up the stew pot, and that, like, really blew me away because I've been thinking about the stew pot for 30 years with very fond, melancholy kind of memories.
I've been looking for you!
I've been waiting for you!
That is hilarious!
I've been waiting.
But wait, your mother made me say that first?
Yes.
Hilarious.
Yes.
But
yes.
What a beautiful message she gave you. So I'm so glad I finally...
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, hello.
I'm feeling very grateful that this happened today. Honestly, I'm very overwhelmed and in shock. And this happening today really just validates my belief in mystery and the universe and synchronicity all at once.
Bye-bye, and I hope you get that stew pot. I gotta go. Sorry to read and run.